If you want to test your blood to know what blood type you are, fortunately, there's an easy, simple, and affordable way to do this at home using the Eldon Blood Typing Kit. My name is Leslie Samuel, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to determine your blood type at home. So let's do it. The ABO grouping system is the one that we use to classify your blood type as either type A, B, AB, or O. And the Rh group is what we use to classify your blood type as either positive or negative. For a review of all of that, check out the last video. I'll link to it in the description below. Well, as great as it is to know all of that theory, how do you know what blood type you are? Well, fortunately, EldonCard Biologicals has created a very simple system for figuring this out. And you can get these kits on Amazon for under 10 bucks. They have individual packs for $8.29 at the time that I'm making this video. And in fact, I got a two-pack for $15.79. I'll leave links to the different packs in the description below. Now I'm going to walk you through exactly how to use this kit so that you don't make any mistakes. It's pretty straightforward, but there are a few things that you want to pay attention to. Okay, we're going to go ahead and open up this package and see what we have on the inside. Get rid of that. You will see right here we have this other packaging, and this is where we're going to have the actual Eldon card. So I'm going to keep it closed for right now until we're ready to use it. But let's see what else we have in here. Okay, we have this little piece of plastic. It's basically when you're finished with your test, you can use this to kind of laminate the actual card so that you can keep it for future reference. Here we have the Eldon sticks. We have four of these. And you'll see how we use this pretty soon. I'll put that right here. And next we have this. This is the lancet. This is what we're gonna use to puncture our skin and get the blood. Now don't worry, it's not gonna hurt that much. Let's put that here. Then we have an alcohol swab to sterilize your finger before we puncture the skin. And then we have this little plastic pipette. This is what we're gonna be using to put little drops of water on the card. And the last thing we have inside are the instructions. We don't need these instructions because I'm gonna show you how to do it. But I do recommend for you to read the instructions if you're doing this yourself. I've done this before, so I know the steps. Now, there are two additional things that you need that aren't in the package. First, you need a little bit of drinking water. And no, this is not for you to drink. You're gonna see how we're gonna use it in a second. And lastly, you need some kind of a stopwatch, a timer, or a clock. Technically, you don't need this. There are just some steps that are gonna require you to count for like 10 seconds. So you can just count in your head. I want to be super accurate, so I'm using an iPhone stopwatch because obviously if I use an Android, it wouldn't work out that well. Okay, I'm sorry, I'm kidding. All right, let's make this happen. I'm gonna go ahead and open up my Eldon card package. You wanna be careful with this because you don't wanna actually tear the card that's on the inside. So I'm gonna open that up. And there we have it. Now, as you can see on the card, we have these four circles right here. In this one, you can see we have the anti-A antibodies. I don't know if you can see that. Maybe if I bring it closer. There you go. Anti-A antibodies, anti-B antibodies, anti-D antibodies. This is the one for determining if you're RhD positive or negative. And then we have the control. It basically contains all of the same stuff that we're using in all of the others, except that it doesn't have any actual antibodies. The idea is that if you see agglutination in any of these, it tells you that the antigens for these antibodies are present. So if you have agglutination in the anti-A circle, that person has type A blood. If you see agglutination in the anti-B circle, you know it's type B. If you see it in both of these, you know it's type AB. And if you don't see it in either of these, you know that it's type O. Once again, for a more in-depth explanation, check out my last video. Now, if you see any agglutination in the anti-D circle, then that person is RhD positive, Rh positive. And lastly, you shouldn't see any agglutination in the control circle. If there's agglutination there, you did something wrong or there was some cross-contamination, the test is all messed up, get rid of it and do it again. All right. We're gonna go ahead and get ready to do our test. The first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna separate these four Eldon sticks. So this is one, and I'm gonna put this right here by anti-A, and then I'm gonna put one by anti-B, we're gonna put one by anti-D, and one by the control. We don't want any mixing or cross-contamination. That's why they have these four individual Eldon sticks. Now, what I need to do is place one drop of water in each of these circles. So I'm gonna come here, get some water, And then I'm just gonna drop one drop here, making sure not to touch the thing so that we don't get any kind of cross-contamination. Go ahead and take the alcohol swab. I'm gonna do it on my middle finger. And I'm gonna swab a few times just to make sure it's nice and sterilized. Then I'm gonna let it dry a little bit. Then the next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this end here, I'm gonna twist it. And then I'm gonna pull it out. Now you wanna be very careful with this because this is a one-shot thing. If you accidentally activate it, that's it. You can't use it again. So be very careful. I made that mistake once. I had to get a new test. Don't be like me. So I'm gonna go ahead now and press it towards my finger. And then I'm gonna press this. You ready? Let's do it. There we go. All right, that didn't hurt much. And I'm gonna do that so that I can press my finger, massage it a little bit to get a decent amount of blood. Then I'm gonna take the Eldon sticks and get one little thing of blood. And I'm gonna drop that here. I'm gonna get the one for anti-B. Get some blood, drop that here. I'm gonna get some blood here, drop that here. And last one, in the control group, we've got that there. Then I'm gonna wipe off that extra blood because I don't wanna go around bleeding all over the place. All right, so this is when I'm gonna start to mix things around. I'm gonna do it with each one of these. I'm gonna go ahead and set a timer just so that I can get an idea of when 10 seconds have passed. But I'm gonna mix it around for about 10 seconds in each circle. So I'm gonna start it here, and then I'm gonna mix it, just to get it well dispersed. Okay, that's that one. Then I'm gonna do the same thing over here. Okay, let me mix it from this angle so that you can see it a little better. Mix it. I can already see something happening here. All right, and lastly for the control group, this is the one that we shouldn't expect to see anything going on. For about 10 seconds. All right, we are good. Now I'm gonna dispose of these Eldon sticks because we don't need them anymore. And for the next step, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna lift this up. And I am gonna hold it down like this at an angle of 45 degrees for about 10 seconds. Then I'm gonna go in the opposite direction for about 10 seconds. And then on the side, 45 degrees for about 10 seconds. And then the other side, 45 degrees for about 10 seconds. And that's pretty much it. At this point, I can just let it dry, but we can actually evaluate our results. Now, as you can see for my blood, I don't have any agglutination in the anti-A circle or in the anti-B circle, which tells you that I don't have any of these antigens in my blood, which means that I am type O. But you can see here there's agglutination in the anti-D, which tells you that I'm RhD positive. So I'm actually type O positive. And that's pretty much it. I'm done. What you can do now is just put this somewhere so that it can air dry. You wanna basically leave it until it's completely dry, and then you have this little piece of sticky plastic. You can take off the paper and use that to laminate this just for it to be protected, and you can keep it safe for a long period of time if you need that. So there you have it. As I mentioned, it's a pretty straightforward and simple process, and anyone can do it at home. I'll link to the different packs in the description below. The link is an affiliate link. What that means is if you purchase after clicking on that link, I do get a small commission. I might get a few cents, and we can use those few cents to take over the world. No, but in all seriousness, it's just a simple way to support the channel, and it doesn't cost you any extra. That is it for this video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.